This is my podcast. This is my podcast. Leroy Furious, the Leroy Fury cast. This is my podcast. This is my podcast. This is my. I say what the fuck I want, bitch.
I'm listening to a Jaguar Wright interview. It's amazing. She is amazing. Oh, she's saying a lot of wild shit. I got headphones on. Whoa! Oh my gosh, she's saying names right now. I got headphones on. She's going off. I'm also watching Hannibal. Hold on, I gotta pause because she's going off. I gotta pause it. Leroy Fury cast. This should be episode 112, where the players dwell. I recently stopped caring about stand-up comedy, but like the bullshit that goes along with it. I'm not gonna quit stand-up comedy. I'm gonna keep doing it till I die, and I could die soon. So yeah, I'm gonna do it till I die. Hopefully till I'm in my 80s. I'm 29 right now. But you could die anytime. But anyway, I did a show at the same spot I did a show before, when the audience member, who was a homosexual man, kept talking. It's on the old episode called Gotta Be Loud. Something similar happened. It was a little better though. This time it was gay women. Why is it always the homosexual people that are loud and annoying that when I'm on stage doing comedy? Everyone else is just cool, calm. Some gay people love my jokes, shout out to them, but every time it happens, there's always someone that might be on the LGBTQ spectrum. They're always interrupting me and being loud and stuff. I don't know what's up with that. I'm a straight man just trying to survive, just telling my jokes. But last time it was a gay dude who would be super loud and annoying. This time it was lesbian ladies. And I really didn't care, because like, this is what I did. I tried to not do comedy on today's Saturday, the 22nd, February 2023. I tried to not do comedy on Friday. I said, I'm going to take a shower, I'm going to put clothes on, I'm going to leave the house. But I'm going to leave the house late so I can miss the bus. So maybe I can't make it to do comedy. So I, before I got in the shower, I looked at the clock and said, all right, I gotta be out of the house in about 45 minutes. Let me, balance my checkbook, which is code word for, Asturbating May. So I said, all right, let me, balance my checkbook. So I put a little movie on, balance my checkbook. I said, all right, I felt good. I feel relaxed. All right. I still got like 40 minutes left until I gotta go. Let me play some video games. So I play a little bit of UFC. Then I said, alright. Now it's like I got like 13 minutes to leave. Maybe 17 minutes. So I got 17 minutes to leave. And I said, alright, I'm gonna go ahead and take a shower. I take my shower and I get out of the shower. And it's like, you know, 4 minutes left. I said, oh, I gotta be dried off and ready to leave in 4 minutes. So I do that, and by the time I'm done, I leave the house. While I'm walking to the bus stop, I see I got like 13, maybe 10 minutes to make it to the bus stop. I'm like, oh man, I got 10 minutes to make it to the bus stop. Hope I make it. So I'm walking at a moderate pace. So then I'm walking to the bus stop, and as I'm walking to the bus stop, the bus is still there, and I'm like, oh man, if I was there 2 or 3 minutes ago, I could have probably been on the bus, but screw it. So I'm walking to the bus stop, the bus driver drives past me, I say, hey, I try to flag him down, like, hey, stop, you're leaving without me, and the bus drives away, and I said, oh man, I missed the bus. Then I go to the bus stop, and I just sit there for like 10 minutes. And just look at like funny videos on my phone. And then I get up and say, alright, ain't no more buses coming. Guess I can't do comedy today. So then I walk back home, and I have great parents. So you know what happened? They said, why are you home so early? I said, oh, I missed the bus. They said, you missed the bus? We can give you a ride. And I said, all right. So I took the ride, and they drove me all the way to the venue. I walk in there. I go say hi to everybody. I'm cordial. I chat to another comic about the Snowfall series finale. Then I set up my camera and everything. And I go first. I get on stage. I go first. And then, I do my joke. And like in the beginning of my joke, this is one girl who's, she looks nice too. She looks very nice. But she's very energetic. Like super energetic. Like she had a fat butt and she had wireless headphones on. Not earphones, headphones. So, you know, like she got a lot of energy. She had headphones on in the comedy club. So she says, hey, can we? Is this a VIP section over there? I said, oh, no, no VIP sections here. Just sit anywhere. So she says, okay. And she looks kind of nice, dark-skinned woman, T-shirt and jeans. She sits down up close to where the comics will be performing at. And I guess she's waiting for someone to come in and sit beside her. So I start my set off. I'm like 2 or 3 minutes in, and she's on this, like, sitting by the stage, waving somebody down to come sit by her. And I stop telling my joke, and I say, hey, yo, come over here. And, like, I don't care, because I really don't care anymore about stand-up comedy. I must keep trying to be funny and keep doing it. I just don't care. Like, I just say, hey, yo, come on, come over here, you know. Tell the dude, and then the dude comes on by the stage, and he sits beside the girl, and I keep telling my jokes. And I tell jokes that are funny, people are laughing, and the people on stage that want people to come sit beside, they laughing extremely loud, and they're having a really good time. They're having such a good time that they're actually talking over my set. Like, I tell a funny joke, they say, ah, I know that's right, I know that's right, I know that's right. Mind you, this venue where I did comedy at, it's the only place where this happens during the showcase. Every other place, the audience shuts the fuck up, and they listen to the comics. They laugh or they don't laugh. They don't respond with verbal words. They don't try to have conversation. They just respond, and it's like, all right. They respond with laughs or silence. But at this particular place I'm stuck at, and I can't get in any other rooms. They're Illuminati rooms. The other rooms that have great showcases, they're Illuminati rooms, gatekeepers, you know, that whole thing. I don't complain about that. I'm not in the Illuminati. I can't get on the stage. Fuck it. I go where I can't get on. And so I'm doing my thing, telling my jokes, and they just sucked all the energy out of me. And I'm just on stage just like, hey, guys, I didn't want to come here today. I missed the bus, and my parents drove me, so that's why I'm here. I'm here because I have good parents. So I keep telling my jokes. And I have this energy the whole time. No enthusiasm whatsoever. I'm just vocal frying it up. Just, you know, speaking like this. Because I didn't care at all. But, yeah, eventually, I was just talking. And then I started telling more jokes. And while I'm telling jokes, the people sitting by me on the stage that were talking and laughing at my jokes. Mind you, they're laughing the loudest at my jokes. And they're also talking while laughing. They're having a really good time. And I didn't care because I'm like, they're having a good time. Fuck it. They could have a good time. Let them have a good time. They're enjoying themselves. I'm not having a good time, but I'm going to be gone when I'm done with my set anyway. So I'm sitting there talking. And there's a guy in the back who's laughing at my jokes quietly because no one wants to laugh loud. They don't want to give me that kind of enthusiasm and pep in my step. They don't want to give me the kind of joy and happiness. They just, it's confidence. They don't want to boost my confidence and self-esteem too high. So they like, they don't laugh aloud. They just go, yeah, you were funny. And I couldn't tell I was funny because you laughed so quietly. You just showed teeth and had no enthusiasm. So this one dude in the back starts filming me. He pulls his phone out and he's filming a little bit of my set. Probably collecting it so he could, like, finger himself to it, I don't know, or post it on Instagram or something. I didn't care. I should have got on stage like this, just pull my mask down and just didn't show my face so that no one knows that it's me trying to be funny. But I might just link the set into this podcast, let you hear the jokes, because I don't care that much. I'm not trying to end my life, nothing like that. I love my life, but it's just, you know, I didn't care for it at all. I gotta take a shit right now, by the way. I gotta take a shit. Also, I'm thinking about the fact that I know Guardians of the Galaxy 3 might be shitty as hell. Something tells me we're gonna get Adam Warlock for like 15 seconds. Something tells me that I'm gonna see it in the hood for $6 because I'm unemployed. And I'm gonna have to deal with people talking while the movie's on. I'm gonna just be like, oh god, shut the fuck up. People gotta talk while the movie's on. Just fucking pay $6. That's what I paid for. $6. And then when the movie's over, there's an after credit scene, and the fucking people that clean the theater, they gotta turn the lights on so I can't see the screen. After credit scene, because the lights are on, I gotta wait like, what was 2 months to watch it on digital so I can see the after credit scene in all of its glory. In all of its, like, bright glory. My teeth look very white right now, but they're not. Like, shit. My family's gonna pay my way to see Fast and Furious 10. So I'm cool with that. And I don't speak loud either. I noticed I don't speak very loud. I did a set at Library Tavern on Thursday. And I spoke very low. I'm not a loud guy. No, I should speak up, but I won't. Because I don't care enough to do so. But as long as people are summoning me to do comedy, I'm going to keep doing comedy. If no one summons me, that's cool too. I'm not really tripping off that. You know, I'm very relaxed and calm. Very chill and normal. Twitch obviously banned Kai Cenat because he's black. No real rant, rhyme, or reason about it. They banned him because he's fucking black. It's raining outside right now. It's drizzling. I can't hear anymore. I think it stopped. But, I'm not even depressed. I just don't care of things. I don't care about things anymore. I'm going to keep eating and showering and working out. I'm not, like, depressed. I don't have a legit care for most things in the world right now. I just don't. I don't need a friend. I don't need a hug. I don't need some pussy. I just need food, water, and shelter. Not really shelter. Just clothes on my back. Keep putting clothes on my back. I might buy some stuff off Amazon. Because Jeff Bezos is a fucking genius. And he really knows what he's doing. So I might have to, like, you know, figure out some shit like that. Oh, Catherine Hot Shelly, who the fuck is that? Who are you? Wave, wave. What's up, man? But, I'm gonna screenshot that, because I don't know who the fuck that is. Man. Yeah, and, I had a family member who saw me walking. They saw me on my long walk. They saw me on my long walk, and they were like, yo, I think I saw you. You had the same clothes on. Walking by this place that I be at. And I was like, oh, I don't be over there. It was me. They saw me. But I didn't see them. They definitely saw me walking over there. They should have said, hey, is it you? Want a ride? They didn't give me a ride. So I said, no, it wasn't me. Yeah, people be seeing me walking out late at night. It's dangerous. But do I care if it's dangerous? No, I call for the smoke. I want the death smoke. Don't want to die, but I want the death smoke. Well, what are you going to do to me? Do it. I want to know what you're going to do, because this shit worse than death. What are you going to do? I don't care about the end. The ending is not that scary to me. So I walk very far. Late at night. While it's dangerous. And I do not care. Rip this tape off. What game was this? Certificate of Authenticity.
Had that on for years, man. I gotta vacuum this room. I gotta get all the dust up. I gotta get my 100 push-ups in. I've been doing them a lot. After I saw the whale, gotta get back at it. I don't want to slow up, slack up with my strength. Gotta get my strength back. Had an intense workout last Saturday. 7 days ago, had an intense workout.
a lot of fun. I had a workout partner. She was cool, very polite and nice. And my thighs were on fire when I fit. They were, the muscle was so painful, and I didn't heal up till Thursday. So it's like Saturday I had the workout, and then Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. It took 5 days for me to get my strength back. And now it's Saturday, and my thighs feel okay. They don't hurt as much anymore. An intense workout, man. When your workout partner is vocal, it always works out. You gotta have a vocal workout partner. You can't be working out with somebody that's just like, all right, push it to the limit. Motherfucker, say, hey, you fucking fat fuck. Get the goddamn job done. Do what the fuck you supposed to be doing. Get the fucking job done. Make this shit happen right now, motherfucker. You don't fucking listen, do you? I told you, get back to that tempo. Why'd you speed it up? Get slower again. I needed that. And that's why I will be seeing that personal trainer damn near every month or every other month. I don't know yet. Not sure. I sweated so much, too. I sweated so much. Like, I wish I had a video camera filming me so I could saw, because I don't film myself working out. That's, like, douchebag shit. Like, unless you're an athlete, why are you filming yourself working out? Are you a personal trainer? Are you telling everybody you're working out? Like, what are you doing? I follow a lot of workout pages on Instagram, though. I like seeing dark-skinned women work out. It's something about dark-skinned women in shape. With or without abs, but I like the abs. The abs are always nice. Like a dark-skinned woman with abs, like Jade Cargill, it's always nice to see that. Because there's like a stigma that black women don't exercise when they do. A lot of them do. Not the majority. Not like 90%, but like there's a nice percentage of that do. And they fucking get it in the gym. They get it in the gym. I've been learning a lot from this past year. I learned that people that don't want you around them, they won't have you around them. They'll live their life so that you will not be around, and you have to be okay with that. And I'm okay with that. I'll be like, you know what? I'm fine. That's cool with me. If I'm not around you. There's so many people in the world to be around. If two people don't want to be around you, there's so many more you can be around, and you need the company. So I'm all good with that. I'm pretty good on that. This is like a nice fireside chat. I have a werewolf mask staring at me. It's my werewolf mask. I have to clean my bedroom up a little bit. It doesn't look that nice right now. It looks decent, but not that nice. I like it. If I like it, I love it. Like, it's all, as long as I like it, I'm pretty good. As long as I like it, I'm doing pretty good. As far as I can tell, I gotta set this mirror up. I have a mirror I'm gonna set up in my room so that I can see when people walk past me. I like to see that. I gotta figure out how to do that. How to get the mirror in my room set up properly so I can see my full surroundings. Security is very prevalent in my life. Let's do some ChatGPT. I went on ChatGPT. And I typed in some stuff, and it's some interesting stuff. I like what I typed in a lot. I like it a lot. I'm interested in seeing what goes on. Let me see. Hold on. I like Future. Flo Milli. Flo Milli had one of the most amazing Coachella sets. Flo Milli's Coachella set was great. The Weeknd performed on Metro Boomin. Metro Boomin deserves every fucking dollar he gets. He is so goddamn talented. Future, hold on. She belongs to the streets. I like Future. Future performed there too. They performed Double Fantasy. Can't wait for the Idol. It looks so good. I got a nice Donald Trump flow when I talk. I love it. It's amazing. I'm a huge fan of it. That's why I can't vote for that motherfucker. I relate to him too much. I can't vote for nobody that reminds me of me. Fuck out of here. Here it goes right here. But yeah, Flo Milli, Pusha T, The Weeknd. They did the thing at Coachella. They killed it. I got the Childish Gambino Coachella set that I wanted. I lost it, but I got it again from a Chinese website. Thank you, China. I'm trying to get Doja Cat's now. She gotta find it. I don't know where it is, but she crushed it. She should have headlined instead of Harry Styles. Like, what the fuck was he headlining for? Yeah, I'd much rather see Doja Cat than Harold Styles. even though she'd rather fuck Harry Styles than me, I still rather see her, because I don't think with my dick all the time. I think with my ears. Alright, I typed in on ChatGPT. I typed in, I just love Flo Millie so much. Flo Millie is so fucking good. Flo Millie is just so amazing on the damn Coachella. But yeah, here goes my, hey, Spend It Like I Print It came into my life. That's cool. He's a cool guy. This is a public service announcement, though. All right. This is my ChatGPT I typed in. I typed in Omni-Man beats Goku. I typed in Omni-Man gives an explanation on how he beat Goku. Because anime fans swear that Goku is the baddest motherfucker alive. So I say, you know what? I'm going to do a ChatGPT explaining why Omni-Man from Invincible can crush Goku, and this is my speech by Omni-Man on how he beat Goku from ChatGPT. All right, here we go.
I am Omni-Man, the Viltrumite warrior among you. I have faced many challenges in my lifetime, but none quite as overrated as Goku. He is a warrior with a so-called limitless power. Quotation marks, limitless power. But in reality, he is just an exaggerated myth. Goku's supposed strength and power comes from a whimsical belief that he is the strongest fighter in the universe. He foolishly pursues power for the sake of power and not any real purpose. Not for any real purpose. In contrast, I am more disciplined in my use of power to ensure that the universe remains safe. I defeated Goku with ease due to his lack of discipline and foresight. He was constantly overpowered by his opponents because he never took the time to understand his competition. He never took the time to hone his skills or analyze his opponent's weaknesses. In our battle, I found his weakness, which was his inability to see past his own limitations. He never believed that anyone could be stronger than him, which led to his downfall. With my superior strength and tactical abilities, I delivered a swift and decisive blow to end the battle. As I stand here before you, I am reminded of the importance of discipline and strategy. Anyone can have great power, but only those who are disciplined and strategic can truly achieve greatness. I am honored to be a Viltrumite and to have had the opportunity to face such a renowned fighter.
That's just him explaining how he beat him. That's just him explaining. I have another one I'm going to read right now. I should save it for next week because it's hilarious. I'm not going to tell you what it is, but it's hilarious. And it's so hilarious. It's so hilarious. I'm not going to give it to you now. I'm going to wait till next week. But, yeah, I just been having fun in life. Doing very little stand-up comedy. I don't care about it as much as I used to once before. I stopped caring so much. I'm trying to care. It's just like at this point, if you want to talk while I'm on stage, I'm going to let you talk. I'm not going to stop you. I'm not going to say, shut the fuck up. This is my life's passion. You got to be quiet. No, I'm not. I'm not going to shut you up. I'm going to talk while you talk. And then the whole room's going to be chaotic. And everyone's going to have a bad time. And it's not going to be my fault. It's going to be your fault. Because I'm not going to shut you up. I'm just going to keep talking. I'm not going to shut you up. I'm just going to keep talking. And just, I'm not going to be defeated. I'm just going to sit back and just relax and smoke this imaginary pipe. Just, because I'm going to be relaxed regardless. I'm going to find my relaxation. I'm going to be relaxed. I'm going to be easy. I'm going to be easy living. I'm going to be good and comfortable. I'm going to be good and comfortable. I'm not going to argue with you because you want to be a dickhead. And you want all the attention because you're a big baby. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to chill. I'm going to chill and relax. I'm going to be cool. I'm going to be calm. I'm going to be very, very collected. I'm going to be collected to the point where you don't even know what collected means anymore. Cause I'm so collected. I'm just so, like, good. I'm not gonna argue. I'm gonna sit back and be cool, man. I'm gonna relax. Banshees of Inisherin didn't get, they got like one Oscar. Everything Everywhere All at Once just swept. I was watching that show with The Rapist on it. David Cho, The Rapist. I was watching The Rapist show Beef on Netflix. David Cho, The Rapist. By the way, Casey Affleck, 2 sexual harassment charges against him. He's in Oppenheimer. Robert Downey Jr. went to prison, got out, became Iron Man, and Sherlock Holmes. Let me see, I'm trying to think who else. There's so many people. Louis C.K. jacked off, sexually harassed women, jacked off in front of their faces. They agreed to it first, but he still did it. Just put out a 3rd special post-2020. The first one was self, all 3 of them were self-financed, self-released. One of them won a Grammy. Another one, one of them won a Grammy, and the other one, Ed Cardin's are from my sound. whatever, she just typed. Someone typed Ed, what are the Ed Cardin's for? And then they went away. Yeah, they left. Alright, whatever. Yeah, you put out 3 self-released stand-up tapes, stand-up specials. Pretty funny, 2 of them. I'm on the 3rd one right now. He put out 3 of them. One of them got a Grammy, the other one got nominated. And he just put this one out, and he started off talking about slavery, because, you know, everyone's obsessed with black people. Just obsessed. Because when you say slavery, you're not talking about the old slaves of, like, some other time and dimension, the Italians and the Irish. You talking about niggas. Talking about niggas. Everyone talking about slavery. They talking about niggas. They ain't talking about no other slavery. But yeah, I'm watching that. I gotta get back into it. Get into it, ya. Get into it, ya. Get into it, ya. Get into it, ya. Yeah, man. Everyone's obsessed with us. Always obsessed with us. It's a sick obsession, but they have it nonetheless with us. Zombieland 1, Zombieland 2. How about you? Don't breathe. But, yes. And, I'm just trying to work out my life right now. My life's going good. It's actually going good. Better than I thought it would go. I keep thinking about the fact that I used to get bullied for being happy, though. Like, I didn't do anything to anybody. I was just happy and people would pick on me. That's crazy to me. That's so gay. Niggas, it's girls everywhere. Niggas would pick on me. Like, yo, it's girls here. You talking to me. Bothering me, but it's girls here. Like, what are you doing? The weirdest. That's why I avoid people at all costs. I stay away from people all the time. I don't like when people bother me. Just leave me alone, please. It's not worth it. Just stay away. If you say you saw me in public and you see me at home, say, hey, I saw you in public wearing the same thing, I'm going to say, wasn't me. Must have been a doppelganger. Must have been a doppelganger, because I wasn't there. I really got to take a shit, but it's not like a crazy one. It's like it's just sitting there. I could hold it for a while. I won't get fat if I don't let it out. Just a little backed up, but I'll let it out. You can lose weight through breath as well, even exhaling. This is funny. Beanie number 19. She used to be a little chunky, then she lost all that weight. Keep on fucking them white boys, they'll get you skinny, bitch. Black man gonna make you, gonna keep you chunky. Feeling good about yourself and shit. Gonna boost your confidence, bitch. You on the right train, but the wrong track, bitch. That's what pimps be saying sometimes. Should I put on Top 5? I like Chris Rock. There Will Be Blood. Perfect movie. There Will Be Blood. I like this movie. I'll drink your milkshake. I'll drink it up. This is Smooth Chat 109. Jive. But,
Ah, it's a Harvey Weinstein movie. He makes some good movies. Horrible person, but made some great movies back in the day. But, yeah, I was talking about all the, like, people that's creepy and shit, like Casey Affleck, Ezra Miller, kidnapped somebody, choked a woman out on camera, was wanted in Hawaii, but he's just running around free. David Cho straight up raped a woman's mouth and admitted to it. No one even asked him, he just admitted to it. And he's on Netflix series and shit. Casey Affleck has 2 sexual harassment charges against him, and he's still in Oppenheimer, but everyone's making such a big, great fuss over Jonathan Majors. Like, Jonathan Majors is just, they just can't keep that man. Like, everyone, like, publicists dropped, everyone dropped. Like, what the fuck? Like, because that's, he being black in Hollywood, man. I think if he saves his money properly, leaves white women alone, and just sticks to his guns, he could probably sign like a 10-picture deal with Tubi, do some Master P movies, maybe work with Kev on Stage or Tyler Perry or Lee Daniels. Somebody might mess with him or something. But he can keep acting. He's not going to go to prison enough. He's going to keep on acting, hopefully. I'd like to see him continue to act. It's just, you know, gotta leave them white hoes alone, player. Them white hoes, they set you up, man. Gotta stick with your own people. I only fucked 2 white girls when I first started having sex, and I ain't going back. I'm sticking with the chocolate. Once you go black, you don't go back. It's real. I can't find no Latin women I want, no Asian women I want, but it's a whole lot of black women that are the best, who I respect the most. That's who I respect the most. That movie Sisu looks really good to watch on my 8-inch tablet. Like, I really want to watch Sisu on my 8-inch tablet. I don't want to watch Sisu on an actual, whatchamacallit. I don't want to watch it on a big screen at all. I really don't want to watch Sisu on a big screen. I would not like to do that at all. I would much rather just watch it on my tablet. It looks like a good action movie. You know, they're killing the Nazis, and they got the Volkswagens and the Hugo Boss and all of that on. Probably wearing some Adidas socks. I don't know, whatever else they wore. Porsche designed some shit for them. One of the first Volkswagen in Jerry Seinfeld is Jennifer. Gary Sheffield's not a fan of Nazis, but he has a Porsche, like 75 Porsches. And he's not going to get rid of them or sell them. He's going to keep them because, you know, that's Jerry Seinfeld's type of thing. So what? I wasn't there during the Holocaust, dude. I'm going to keep, like, you know how he talks, Jerry Seinfeld. What's the deal with Hitler? I'm a fan of Gilbert Gottfried as well. I was listening to Gilbert Gottfried's podcast. Rest in peace, Gilbert Gottfried. Aladdin. I was listening to Gilbert Gottfried's podcast, and he had Neil deGrasse Tyson on a repeat from like the second season of Cosmos. Cause ever since they died, they just been re-releasing old episodes of the podcast every week, and it's really cool and awesome. Because he had Neil deGrasse Tyson on, and Neil deGrasse Tyson was talking about Cosmos, saying that he's not going to host it forever. He's definitely going to pass the torch the same way that Carl Sagan died and kind of passed the torch to him because he met Carl Sagan. But for Cosmos, he was talking about how he's going to have another host do it. And he said, I think Gilbert should host. Gilbert, you'd be a great host of Cosmos. By the way, Star Talk, such a good podcast. Him and Chuck Nice. He had Lynn Coppolis on it, but now he has Chuck Nice, and it's really cool. I like that podcast, Star Talk, Neil deGrasse Tyson. But he was talking about how, like, he wanted Gilbert Gottfried to be the new host. And Gilbert, see if you can say this for me. 14 billion years ago, the Big Bang occurred and Earth was formed. Can you say that, Gilbert? And Gilbert Gottfried said,
14,000 years ago. The Big Bang happened in the Ice Witch form.
So funny. And I think in a comic book, Gilbert played Nick Knack of the DC Comics, but in the actual cartoons, he played Mixie Spitlick. And I think that James Gunn, in his Superman Legacy script, he should have Mixie Spitlick be the main villain. And who could play Mixie Spitlick? Another guy with a weird sexual charge, Aziz Ansari. I think Aziz Ansari would be a great live-action Missy Spitlick, you know?
It would be weird to see him, though, because he's all, like, a depressing comedian now, with a hoodie on stage, like, yeah, man, I don't care about nothing anymore, dude. I got in trouble, so now I don't care. See, that's different between me and him. Like, a lot of comedians get in trouble, and their whole style changes up, and this real laid-back demeanor. I didn't get in any trouble. I just don't care, because I keep getting stuck doing rooms where people talk while I'm on stage, and it's like, why can't it be good here like other places? Because I can't perform at other places because they're all Illuminati rooms. So I'm like, yo, this is the room I can get on. And it makes sense that this is the one I can get on. People just bother me and talk while I'm on stage. And it's like, what the fuck, yo? That's so annoying, dude. But I'm just going to keep... I don't care. I'm just going to live through it all. Let life pass me by. I might go on the internet and buy some new pants. Buy some jeans or something. Even though I have jeans, I should save the money for food. But I'm not going to starve to death because I live in America and we have food all over the place. Even some of it's free. So, like, should I save my money for food or should I just buy the jeans? Even though I don't need jeans, but I want some jeans. I want some yellow jeans. Let me look up yellow jeans. I'm going to look up yellow jeans. 5 people came in this motherfucker. Yay, yay. That's what's up. Whoop-dee-doo, bada-da-da. Don't care. Let's see. Stop taking black children to church. Take them to self-defense classes, business seminars, or gun range. I agree with that. Stop telling black people to counter love with hate. Stop telling black people to counter hate with love. You don't counter a left jab with a hug. That's true. Rate Instagram? Sure, I'll rate it. No, I'm not leaving. I'm not doing all that dumb shit, bitch. Fuck out my face, yo. Oh, she made her page private again. I'm just gonna screenshot it and share it when I feel like it. Latris on the Minjay. She bought a blue check. I'm disappointed. Highly disappointed in you, girl. I need some answers. You see what's going on. I got a DM. Bet you it's not a woman. Oh, someone else replied to my story. Oh, yeah, this video is funny. This guy was skiing and he fell down a hole. That's very funny to me. All right, Will Smith got a new video out. I like that song.
After a successful hunt.
In the jungle, the mighty jungle, the lion sleeps tonight. It's a familiar sound. That's a really good song. The Lion Sleeps Tonight.
Some of the lions enjoy the music.
I zoomed in too far.
Others seem agitated by it.
That's funny. Others seem agitated by it. Who the fuck is watching that Peter Pan? I want to go on that show where the girls pop the balloons to reject the guy in England. Because it just seems very funny to me how the girls just be like, Star Wars uploads. Just like my video, like my video, like my video. Season 3 is kind of doopy. Space Hitler isn't real. It won't hurt you. Season 3 of Mandalorian was pretty weird. Let me see. The girl popped the balloon.
Introduce yourself to all these girls. What is your name, bro?
My name is Demi. I'm from Nigeria.
My name is Leroy. I'm from Scandinavia.
Hi. Demi from Nigeria. Are you girls liking him, or is it time to pop the balloon?
Damn.
All of them pop the balloon. Damn. I wouldn't be mad to pop. They could pop the balloon for me. Joaquin Phoenix on new movie, Bo is Afraid. Do not take mushrooms and go watch this fucking film. I want to see it. It looks pretty interesting. I'm not going to pay, though. Yo, I found one of my favorite old porn stars. She has an Instagram account now. She's just living her regular life. And I like it. I like seeing her live her regular life. Because she's fucking smoking hot, man. Smoking hot, dude. Very attractive woman. Very beautiful. She has a bigger body now. Like, muscles. Like, she'd be working out. She's a nutritionist now. Looks great. And I like it. And it's awesome.
No one's asking her in the comments about her OF page. No one's bothering her. It's just a normal girl. She's living life, man. That's super cool. See, I'm not in a bad mood. I'm just like, I just don't care anymore. I just don't care about what I used to care about. Who gives a fuck now about whatever? I'm just gonna do stuff now and just live my life. I'm gonna just stand up every day probably. I'm gonna force myself to get out of the house more. I get out of the house more than most people though. Cause a lot of retards say, you don't go anywhere. Like, you don't go outside. Like, I don't go outside. Like, my skin's darker than yours. You do realize I don't own a tanning bed, right? But people are idiots and they don't catch on the context clues. And I have to explain to them, my skin is dark and I don't own a tanning bed, which means that I'm not in the house sitting in a tanning bed. I'm outside and the sun is touching me because I'm actually out of the house going outside and it's making my skin darker. And if I didn't go outside at all, my skin wouldn't be as dark as it is. So I actually do go outside often because I got darker skin. And they'd be like, you don't go outside. And I'd be like, oh, you're fucking dumb. So I can't talk to you. And that's why I'm always alone. Because most people are fucking idiots.
And I don't have time to explain why I'm more intelligent than them. My intellectual levels are just skyrocketing past what little they have going on in their brains. So yeah, that's my take on society. That's all I have to say for now. This has been Leroy Furycast, episode 112, Where the Players Dwell. I'm gonna stop recording this and go take a shit. Then I'm gonna come back and edit it, and I'm gonna post it on YouTube, and then I'm gonna watch it on my tablet, my old phone, my current phone, and my TV. And I'm gonna do that 3 times, and I'm gonna give myself 12 views. So then by the end of the week, when I'm on my next episode, my podcast will have a total of 10 views, because 2 of my views don't matter, because I kind of don't matter. Black lives do matter. I hate Nick Fuentes. Hope something fucked up happens in his vicinity, resulting in his bad news. Him and Pearly Things. Pasty Bitch and Bitch Fuentes. Just Pasty Things and Bitch Fuentes. I wish the worst for both of them, as well as David Duke and George Zimmerman, who stalks children, and Timothy Lohman and Derek Chauvin and Geronimo Yanez and the Asian bitch that shot the girl over orange juice that started the Watts riot, where even more Asian people started shooting black people, and white people just love to live and rejoice in the time where Asian people shot black people. They just love it. So that's why I'm pro-black, and everybody else can suck a fucking asshole, unless you're cool. If you're cool and not racist, I don't care what color you are, I'm cool with everybody, because I'm black, because I was raised to be cool with everybody. I wasn't raised to be a fucking supremacist, but due to the way society is, I have to be a supremacist of the black race. I have to be pro-black, and that's what I am. I'm pro-black. And the only reason Jonathan Majors is going through all of this bullshit is because he's fucking black. Because Casey Affleck has 2 sexual harassment charges against him, and he's still going to be in the new Oppenheimer movie. Also, I love Saweetie, but she's mixed race, so I'll talk about the dumb bitch. So, no, I'm calling her that. I'm fucking playing. I'm playing. She's not a dumb bitch. I would never. But I find it funny how she said she wanted an 8-figure nigga. That's her type. But her album only sold 4 figures, 2,000 copies. So it's like, you want a guy that makes 8 figures, but your album only sold 4 figures. You can't even sell half of the guy. You sold half of the guy you want. You're half. You want a guy that's double you? You want a guy that's 2 of you? 8 figures, you only made 4. And that's why I know that Dante Nero and Patrice O'Neal were right when they say women, they want guys that are better than them. You gotta be better than her. So fellas, if you sell 5-digit copies, if you sell 10,000 copies, you can get Saweetie, because you're automatically better than her. And I like Saweetie. She's beautiful. Her mom fine as fuck. Yeah. But she wants 8-figure nigga, and she only making 4 figures, like 2,000. That's why I love Flo Milli. You still hear her? She had the whole VH1 thing with it. I like Flo Milli's type.
She had the whole VH1 promotion with her album. Bedtime is such a great song. Shout out to Flo Milli. I'm Leroy Furious. This has been Leroy Fury Cast, episode 112, where the players dwell. I'm just... Stop. I don't care. I don't care anymore. I don't care anymore. My hands are tight now. Hands are tight. I don't care anymore. I'm done. Don't care. I'm done.
This is my podcast. This is my podcast. Leroy Furious. The Leroy Fury Cast. This is my podcast. This is my podcast. This is my. I say what the fuck I want, bitch.